to the name of the Lord. The Lord is good and his mercies endureth forever. I am Ezekiel Adeleke Atayiro. I welcome you to a great day. I welcome you to the season of recovery. The Lord has promised us that recovery is a must. Don't forget, I want to give you so many things that you have lost to ignorance. Always emphasizing on this. The Lord is ready to make all things work for you. The Lord wants to settle you mightily, and he will make you work in Jesus' name. How was your night? Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3 says, "Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind stayed on thee, because he trusted in thee." Now listen to this word. God will only keep those that trust in the Lord. He will keep them in perfect peace. There is difference between peace and perfect peace. So when you hear peace, it may not be perfect. There are slippery peace. A lot of people have peace. They have what you call peace, but they discover that it is not a complete peace. But when God is talking about perfect peace, he's talking about complete peace. I pray for you today, this week, as you go out, the Lord will give you perfect peace in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace in your marriage, perfect peace in your business, perfect peace in your health, perfect peace in everything you lay your hands on. Perfect peace, I pray, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace that will surprise you, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace that will connect you, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace that will make a way for you, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace that will give you everything you are hoping on God for, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace that will validate you, receive it in the name of Jesus. As you go out Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, all through this week, I pray in the name of Jesus, receive perfect peace. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace for enlargement, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace for solution, receive it in the name of Jesus. Perfect peace for that your marriage to come, receive it in the name of Jesus. The Lord sent me to tell that lady, you are of age, you are like 42 years. The Lord is saying, I should tell you, you have not married. It's a concern to your family. As a matter of fact, you are serving God very well. You did not look out but God alone. The Lord is saying, it will be if you have perfect peace concerning your marriage. He said to me, I should tell you, in the realm of your spirit, those that are there are people that want to destroy you, want to stop communication between you and me. That means between you and God. And the Lord is saying, he wants to clear them off. But you will see, by this time next year, you'll be talking about, I have my marriage, my name, surname has changed to the name of my husband, and by the grace of God, you will not wait before you start having your children. The Lord is saying, don't say, let me enjoy my marriage a bit. Immediately, tell God, I need pregnancy immediately. The Lord said, I want to compensate you for the years you thought you have lost. I want to give you something special. Can I hear the better amen? Now, somebody you are connecting to this, you are a woman as well. You have laid your hands on so many business, but none of them are actually working for you. The Lord is saying, I should tell you, he wants to show you the secret to what is happening in your life. He will show you through the thoughts in your mind, and don't think otherwise. Immediately you get this, you let me know. You have been struggling, and you have not been able to get things right. There is a woman, you live in Ikoyi. You live in Ikoyi. Your husband is a wealthy man, but you are struggling. You know you are struggling. He's taking care of your children, but he's not taking care of you. Once upon a time, something happened, not infidelity, but your husband lost that trust about you. One way or the other, it has to be with secret things you are doing for your family, and you did not allow your husband to know. You both agree that whenever you want to do something for your family, you should let him know. He will know how to package it and make it well. And there are some things you do for your family that your husband got to know. But husband did not talk up to now. I pray for you today. I want you to shout the loudest amen. You live in Ikoyi, Nigeria, Lagos State. I pray in the name of Jesus, the Lord will enter into the heart of your husband. In the name of Jesus, he will enter into the heart of your husband. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will enter into the heart of your husband. In the name of Jesus, he will enter into the heart of your husband. in the name of Jesus. There is a woman also. Wow. Every woman in the house, I want you to start congratulating yourself. The Lord is set to settle you. You have laid your hand on so many things. As a matter of fact, the present state you have right now is as if day should come. When the day comes, it's as if night should come. You are in the state of giving up, of depression. You are not doing anything. Nothing is working for you. You have laid your hands on so many things. You have traveled out of your country to buy jewelries before. You have laid hands on so many business, but nothing, as we speak, nothing is working. The Lord is saying, He wants to deal with the deity of your family, the name that they gave to you as the name you bear right now. It has to do with a name that one particular woman, a witch, bear in your family. As a matter of fact, your mother, younger sister. Many years ago, both your mother and the younger sister are late. But the Lord is saying, what they have done concerning you is still working. I pray for that woman. Stretch your hands and say amen very well. I pray today in the name of Jesus. Receive God's deliverance. Receive it. 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 In the name of Jesus. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. The Lord asked me to tell that person, He wants to change your season to the best season. You have struggled so much. He wants to compensate you. Let me share this testimony of one of my sons. Came to the office and said, Daddy, I want to praise the Lord for my life. Some years back, you came to my house, you and mommy, to pray for me. And you said, God is going to bless me with land in a very simple way. He's going to come. You don't even have the money when that time comes. It was long years, but the word came to pass last week. The Lord, who can never be insulted, did it. Said, sir, somebody said, a friend of his or of us bought a property at the back of Redeem, and the property happened to be two plots. And the person said, bring whatsoever you have with you. Bring whatsoever. And he said, I have. And the what he has was not even something enough. And to the glory of God, everything was handed over to him. I pray for you today in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever you are believing God for this season shall be released to you in the name of Jesus. Shall be released to you in the name of Jesus. That same God that has spoken many years ago is still alive today. Let me also share this testimony of one of my daughters in the Lord who has been waiting for God for 12 years. The Lord touched them. One day they came to me and they said, Daddy, we want to go for IVF. And I said to them, let me talk to my God. As I was talking to God, that same month or 2 months after, she got pregnant. The Lord said to them, that family, until today, they are rejoicing for the evidence of, let me go to my God and report the case to my God. Are you in any case? Are you fighting any battles? Is as if nothing is working in your life. You have given up hope. I pray for you today. I connect to that same my God that I serve. That same my God will work for you. Work for you. Work for you. Work for you in the name of Jesus. Your hope in God will not be dashed out in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. I want to congratulate you, to wish you happy day. This week will bless you. Everything you put in this week will work for you in the name of Jesus. Favor will work for you. Comfort will work for you. Anointing of God will work for you in the name of Jesus. It shall be well with you in Jesus' name. Amen. Before I go ahead, let me also announce this to you. To the glory of God, Restoration Prayer Hour, we kickstart on Thursday, being the 1st of October. At 5 a.m., we are going to be online. That is GMT. Everyone, I want you to connect to this. GMT plus one. We're going to be online at 5:30. But some things will be showing before that time. We are starting for 30 minutes, 5:30 to 6. God bless you. I love you with the love of God. For prayer, for counseling, or you have something you want to share, and testimony you want to share, plus 234-80-370-79874 is the number to call. I celebrate you. Today is your birthday. Today is your wedding anniversary. It shall be well with you. Celebrate God and enjoy God. Promotion is knocking at your door. I don't know if that person is. You're expecting promotion. Begin to tap into it. The Lord bless you. I want to appreciate everyone that has been reaching out in blessing the work of God in our hand, most especially concerning our building project. The Lord bless you. You want to be part of that? Please, you have a commission account. You can also reach to that number with you. God bless you in Jesus' name. Look at what is written. Under this, you will discover that you have the account to that. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 in Jesus' name, glory. For the next 5 minutes, as you are going, begin to have declaration of personal declaration. What do you want God to do? For test, speak the word, and it will come to pass. It shall be well with you. Amen, 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 in Jesus' name, glory.